grandma's hands. Clapped in church on Sunday morning, grandma's hand. Played a tambourine so well, grandma's hand. Used to issue out a warning. She
the Lord and Savior, Pastor Pettit, all the pastors in the house. Amen. Sister Hall's family. We love Sister Hall. She's a big part of everybody in this church. Matter of fact, she's kind of like my mentor. When I came here, everything she did, it seemed like she wanted me to do with her. And I guess she didn't ask me, she told me. I'm chairman of the Women's Committee. I kind of think she told Pastor Ted Van Rose to finish it for her, but I don't know. You'll never know. But anyway, she's delegation in our mission. I'm a mission sister, I'm a culinary sister. So I didn't know by praying out loud, so she told me in the mission, she said, Sister Watson, you pray. And somebody else do the, I said, you want me to pray? She said, you got to learn it sometimes. So I dropped on my knees and prayed. So in culinary, she taught me that being sick, something wrong with you, it was a time to get more into the church, to work harder in the church. Because when she was sick, she would walk in there and say, what you want me to do? And I said, well, what you want to do? She said, whatever you want me to do. So I put a stool there and gave a towel. I said, tell them to get their drink and wipe it and dry it. Give them a smile and welcome to our church. And she said, I can do that. So she would do that. When I asked her, she come back and asked, Glenn, what you want me to do now? I said, put tea and ice. When you need it, let me know. So she said, Glenn Rose? I said, yes, ma'am. She said, I need ice. I go get it. Sister Hall taught me that being in the mission, when I'm sick and or hurt, I got a lot of things going on in my body that people don't know, but she knew it. She said, if I can do it, you can do it. She called me her son, her daughter, my husband, her son. Now, this is what I asked her. How can I be your daughter and my husband be your son? She said, in God's eyes, we are all God's children. I see through God's eyes, and all of you are my children. So I love Sister Hall, Jackie. You know, I'm there anytime you want. And God bless you all. And thank you.
Resolution from AJ Moore, 1954 Heights. When waves of affliction sweep over our soul, and sunlight is hidden from view, if ever you have tempted to fret and complain, just think of God's goodness to you. Waco, Texas, September 14, 2019. Resolution for Mrs. Mildred Yvonne Branch Hall. Mildred was always steadfast and unmovable in her thinking as a member of the class of 1954 at A.J. Moore High School. Mildred was also our vice president of our class. When there was something to be done, she would get it done. She took initiative. She was always out front on everything. And she loved her school. And you would never have known that she was an only child because she was just full of humor and made you laugh and she loved people. She initiated our class. We went on a cruise in 2004. That was when we were celebrating our 50th year of graduation. And later, 10 years later, we did our 60th year. We did it here in Waco, Texas. And that was October 2014. And 6 more years, we're supposed to have another one. Every 10 years, we get our class reunion. And it was just the class of 1954. As I said, she was full of humor. She loved her children. She loved her children here. She was a loving mother and grandmother who adored her family. They were the love of her life. Remember, family, the 46 times, God is our refuge and strength. Amen. person having trouble. And she loved her church, and she was dealing and sincerely in her church. And I want you to know that I thought this scripture was befitting to Mildred, because Mildred was close to me, and we were really close. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Revelations 2:2. And Mildred was faithful to the end.
Corner of Waco, Texas, and mid-70s on 606 Garrison Street and 1221 Falcon Lane, or 706 Hubert Street was the place to be. Amen. Me and my brother used to get off school bus and walk across over there to Mildred's house, and me and him and Dexter be playing, and you know, everybody else, they was in high school, you know, we had to hurry up and clean that house up for Mildred to get off that bus. That was the type of person she was. But no, she was a virtuous woman. Church going on woman, and she always loved God. You know, I used to call her every Saturday to check on, hold a conversation with her. But she always said, I love you. And tell your wife I love you. But she loved everybody. You know, everybody. She put everybody first. You know, everybody grew up on Hubert Street. You know, not just my generation. Our grandkids, our great-grandkids, that's just a place to be. A two-bedroom house. It was so full. But that's the love that she showed us. You know? And she put God first. No, she loves everybody. You know? No more pain, no more sorrow. You know, she was prepared to go. No, she was prepared to go home. No, this is not home. No, it's all right to mourn. We're here to celebrate her life. Look at the love she sparked out on us. That's what it's all about. You know, my sister and they moved down here. We had moved away, but my sister and little brother, they moved back here. They was over there at 706 Hubert Street growing up. Like I said, that was the place to be. Everybody loved going around Aunt Mildred's house. That was the place to be. You know, and she always gave everybody advice. If they came here for advice, she gave it to them. But man, she said, you make sure you put that advice to use and take it with you. But I'm leaving with this. Hey, I always gave advice. You, under this love, and never turn your back on us, and treating us like your own children. That's what she treated us, like her own children. And the main thing is she took us all in, and she gave us what you wanted. You know, 706 QC is where it all began. Those were the good days. There can be no more days like that, no more. But it's memories. Though you always can remember. No, she might be gone, but she never will be forgotten. Amen.
Amen. God, who's the head of my life, to the ministers in the pulpit, and to the friends and family here, I am here representing her fruit. Dexter said, Braylee, I want you to speak how you want your name in the program. I said, put it the way Mom Mildred would put it. Put Kim in there. Make sure it says Kim. But I want everyone here to look around. Look up in the balcony, look to the back of the choir stand, look around. Now go on and look around. Because see, there's a lesson here. Let your life, you hear me? Let your life be this reflective. We wouldn't be here if she wasn't a woman of God. He says, speak on something, Proverbs 31 something, and I read through it and I said, she's all this, but wait a minute. There's one piece. When her children rise up, they call her blessed. So I call her blessed on this day. Because when I look around, I see the fruit of her labor. So I want y'all to know it's her root in Jesus that creates this kind of fruit. So I just want us all to make sure that our fruit looks like this when it's our turn. Because our turn is sure to come. And to my family, I just say to you guys, be not dismayed, whatever time God will take care of you. Beneath his wings abide, God will take care of you. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, he will. Yes, praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord.
Filipino brands. Get it together. my granny, you know, something this morning, you know, told me to get up and get yourself together. It's going to be all right. My granny molded me. My granny did everything for me.
All right.
Okay.
All right. You got it.
I didn't want for nothing.
Yeah.
Whatever I needed, my granny would provide.
That's right.
When I was younger, you know, being the oldest, you get to see certain things before you. Other siblings that come along. And me and my cousin, he's not here, rest in peace, rest in heaven, Nicholas. I would often sit on the porch, you know, as I learned to get the time down. My granny never drove. I don't know if y'all knew. My granny never drove. She took the bus everywhere. She worked in the nursing home. She was a dietary aide for years. You know, there was a back when, you know, the nurses wore just the all white shoes and the white stockings. I often wait for my granny. She got off the bus right down with Garrison. I got the time down and I would wait. And I would run around there and I see my granny coming. And she would just light up. I had the opportunity to spent a lot of time with Granny. We talked about many things. Yeah. And she prepared me for this moment. Mm-hmm. She would say, baby, I don't know how long I'm gonna be here. But I'm gonna need you to be strong.
Yeah.
She said, I got my wish.
Yeah. No.
She said, I prayed for 18 and a half years.
All right.
That God wouldn't take me from here until you got on.
All right.
18 and a half years. My granny would tell me every week when she wrote me. I'm praying for you every day, baby. I only ask God for one thing. Just allow you to come home before you take me. Before he take me away from here. That's all I want. She said, I don't want nothing else. And God blessed us.
All right. Yes, he did.
That was 12 years ago.
All right. All right.
I promised my granny because she will often remind me. I don't know how she got the word up. But word travels fast. I would walk to my granny's house and she would say, I don't know what you and your brother doing, but I ain't coming back down the highway no more. I done got too old for this. I ain't writing you no letters. I ain't sending you no money. So those were the reminders of how God is good to us. Reminded of certain things. And my granny believed it, man. Everything that my granny did, God had to approve it first.
That's right.
But she wasn't gonna do it.
That's right.
She didn't care how you felt. She didn't care if your feelings got hurt. But she was gonna let you know the business. My granny, we would talk, you know, my granny fought a good fight. And I had the opportunity to spend those days with my granny, you know, spend the night with my granny on the weekends when I would come back into town here recently. And I would sit there and me and granny would talk. I'd walk in the room and she would say, hey, boo, I see you made it. And I would say, Granny, yeah, I'm here. But we're talking about life. Yeah. Granny told me a man would let you down every time.
Ooh, yeah.
But the man I serve, he'll be faithful to you all the time.
Yeah.
Not
not sometime, all the time.
That's right.
To my brothers and sisters, my cousins, Granny loved us all. She loved us all equally. Granny didn't have no favors. Y'all always, you thought I was a favorite. She would often tell me that. But she would always remind me, you know what, Granny ain't got no favors. You know, I love you all equally. Granny, the same things Granny did for me, she did for my brothers and sisters. She did for my cousins. I just came first. Still my deepest regards to everybody that that came to, you know, celebrate my granny life, man. She was the love of my life. But like I say, she prepared me for this moment. You know, but we all go through things, and I know. Just thinking about the things that she told me, lean on God when you're going to do stuff. Don't depend on nobody, only God can help you. And I want to tell my brothers and sisters, y'all continue to do that. My uncles, my aunts, cousins, love you guys. Thank you guys for everything. Especially my uncle, man. My uncle worked overtime, man, to make this beautiful event. But you know what? It wasn't a shadow of doubt in my mind that he was going to go all out. Continue to, you know, we need to continue to stick together, one another, because we love my granny, we won't. And that's what I'll continue to do. You know, my granny work is not done. This is what she built. She built the foundation for what was to come. And our work continues to go on. And it's through our children, through our grandchildren, through our nieces and nephews, through our friends. So thank you guys, love you all, and thank you for being here.
My soul shall make her boast in the Lord, and the humble shall hear and be glad.
All right.
Magnify the Lord with me.
Right.
I don't think y'all heard. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. I stand before you as another fruit. I'd like us to ask all the kids, the BMZ kids, to stand, please.
Amen.
When I say we rise, we ride together, past, present, and future. There's nothing that we wouldn't do for this Hall family. Obedience to God, to Pastor Petty, to Pastor Hall, to Pastor Hunter, and all the ministers on the roster. Proverbs 31 and 28 talks about a virtuous woman. High honors await a great woman, ideally a woman whose family adores her. They revere her. Confidence in herself is good, but her family knows the truth about this woman.
Right.
They know her virtue as well as her flaws. Mm-hmm. Mildred Yvonne Hall, selfless, but a virtuous woman. What comes to my mind is Lois, the grandmother of Timothy. Many times we forget Lois because she's only mentioned once in the Bible. But when you think about it, one encounter with Mildred Hall is enough to last a lifetime. Remembering the early days of the spiritual mothers of the Berkeley Mount Zion Missionary Baptist Church, under the tutelage of Dr. M.T. Thompson, Mildred selflessly placed herself in doing the work of the Lord. I think of the children, choir, the pastor's choir, the youth ministry. Mildred continuously, resourcefully, fearlessly, strong, and boldly led us as kids. It was Sunday afternoons. We would be on 76th Avenue partaking of Sunday dinner.
Yeah.
Mildred said, y'all don't mess my house up. But we was in there regardless. She wanted to make a safe haven for us to be. As a mother and as a grandmother to me, Mildred made sure you understood that she wasn't flawless, but flawless. Striving with a sincere faith and sharing it continuously. We think this is something big, but all we have to do is share the love of Christ daily in our walk. It's continually our responsibility, as it was Mildred Hall's responsibility, to show the groundwork that Christ has set with us in this day and age. Mildred Hall is now a citizen of heaven, y'all.
All right.
Struggles are no more. Dexter, I could see her walking through the gates. She might have bumped into Nicholas. I could see her yonder walking. She just may have walked into Aunt Betty Johnson. Sharon and Stacy, she bumped into Cedric and Miss Kitty Sharon Randolph. Kim, she bumped as well into Eddie Yarbrough, right, our supervisor.
Come on.
Y'all, she made it a point to see Uncle Charlie Langford, BJ. She ran into Katie Eggleston, V.S.C. McGowan,
right,
and Sister Nat on purpose.
Right.
She even ran into Deacon Sylvester Greenwood and said, continue to look out for my son, Dexter Hall. What I can hear her saying as she reached those pearly gates, I shall wear a crown. I shall wear a crown. When it's all over, I shall wear a crown. I tell you what, I shall see his face. I'm going to put on my robe and tell the story. How I made it over.
Right.
Matthew 25 and 21 has become manifest. Well done, thy good and faithful servant. God bless you.
Amen. When you can come to this kind of service, you know you can't be depressed and you can't be sad, because this proves that somebody lived a good life. And so today we're here celebrating a good life. And it's good to celebrate a good life and then to know where that life is going. The family of Mother Mildred Yvonne Branch Hall would like to thank everyone who came to pay their respects to our matriarch. Your prayers, flowers, cards, and words of encouragement were greatly appreciated. May God bless you abundantly for your acts of kindness and compassion. And they didn't tell me to say this, but they'll acknowledge you at a later date personally. If they don't, contact me and I'll handle it. Now, when you live a good life, there's a lot to be said. So I have a bunch of things here, and they want them acknowledged. So sometimes when you've done all you can in the world, and folks appreciate it, you just got to relax and kind of go with the flow. So now this is a little lengthy, but hey, this is the life she lived. All right. There's peace in the promise that life is everlasting. Dexter and family, praying that the understanding and sympathy of those who care will be a comfort to you now, and that the Lord's promise will bring you hope and reassurance in the days to come. With deepest sympathy, love and blessings, Steve and Angela Wright. God will tenderly comfort you. He will give you the strength to endure. 2 Corinthians 1 and 7. To the family of Mildred Hall, it is my prayer that God will provide you with the strength to get through this season of loss. May the love of family and friends provide you with comfort as you celebrate the incredible life of your matriarch. I pray that the upcoming days, weeks, and months are filled with precious memories, and that each of you will be comforted with the memories, images, and life lessons that were left behind. May God be close to you now for strength and comfort, and may his peace overflow in the days to come. Prayerfully yours, Brother Steve Gardner. With sympathy, the staff at Doris Miller YMCA, we're praying for the family. May God bless each of you. We are here if needed. Mr. Melvin, and I'm so sorry, but I cannot read the last name, but it's Mr. Melvin and staff. Amen. I want to let you know that they are thinking of you in this time of sorrow. While the rest of the world carries on as though nothing has happened, remember that others know your world will never be the same. And day after healing day, when you might think people have forgotten, we'll still be caring about you. So sorry for your loss. Love, KK and Matthew, praying for you and your family. What a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. May you find comfort during this time as God strengthens your heart with his love and peace. Deepest condolences and prayers for the family. Reverend Waylon, and I think it's C.S. Sias, okay, and Zion Hill Church family. See, they knew you were Silas, okay. All right. With deepest sympathy, in your time of sorrow, may it ease your pain to know that others are thinking of you. Praying for you and with you, for our hearts are weakened for the loss of our sister. We shall miss her beautiful personality and kind heart. Mission 1, Reverend Melvin Petty, pastor. And we have a little note here from Glenn Rose saying, just if we want to talk, and left the phone number. With sympathy, thinking of you, with a heart filled with compassion and love. May you forever hold on tight to all the memories, sending strength from the Bradshaw and Alley family. Love you. May the love of God give you peace. May the caring of friends give you comfort. May the memories of the one you've lost remain in your heart and give you strength through the days ahead. Love, Hubert Street neighborhood.
All right.
Now see, that's good living when your neighbors want to say something about you. Resolution. Greater St. John Missionary Baptist Church, 1909 Market Street, Oakland, California. Bishop Gregory B. Payton, pastor, General Church. Mother Mildred Yvonne Hall. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, that you may be also. John 14:1-3. Whereas Bishop Gregory B. Payton, the officers and members of the Greater St. John Missionary Baptist Church of Oakland, California, extend our deepest heartfelt sympathy to the family of Mother Mildred Yvonne Hall, who has departed this earthly journey for her heavenly flight. And whereas we surrender to God's infinite will, for he has called his servant from earth to glory, from a labor of love to receive her eternal reward in heaven with our Father. For the word of God declares in 2 Corinthians 5:8, we are confident, I say, and willing rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. And whereas we thank and praise God for the life and legacy of a faithful Christian woman, Mother Mildred Yvonne Hall, now rests in perfect peace with the Father. Although we will miss her and we mourn the loss of her presence, may your heart in the midst of your sorrow be comforted with the assurance that one day God will turn your mourning into joy. For earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. And whereas we recognize Mother Hall as the mother of our friend and brother, Deacon Dexter Hall, we love you, and not only do we offer our prayers and condolences, but we extend ourselves to you in love and support. And we therefore resolve that we pen these resolutions today to express our grief in the loss of our beloved Mother Mildred. And it is the pleasure of the Greater St. John Missionary Baptist Church that this resolution be given to the family and one placed in our church records. Prayerfully submitted, Saturday, September 14, 2019, Greater St. John Missionary Baptist Church, Bishop Gregory B. Payton, pastor.
Sister Ward, can I get you to do this? Can you acknowledge the resolution and where it came from, and then move on to the next one without reading those resolutions?
Okie dokie, you don't want the one read from your church?
You can acknowledge that if we have one.
Okay, All right. Well, next we have resolution. This one is from the Chapel Hill Baptist Church family. Reverend Kenneth B. Hall, pastor, Lily and Judy's secretary. Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church, Beaumont, Texas. Reverend Tommy G. Williams, senior pastor. Sharon Freeman, church clerk. Mount Calvary Baptist Church, Athens, Texas. Reverend Leonard Jackson, pastor. Sister Nancy Solomon, church clerk. Brother Irvin Champion, deacon chair. And Reverend Leonard Jackson, pastor. Resolution, Berkeley Mount Zion. This is coming from the church family. And we have another one from the Berkeley Mount Zion Church in Berkeley, California, coming from the church general, the Reverend Brian B. Hunter, pastor teacher. And we have Greater Mount Olive Baptist Church right here where we're standing today, Waco, Texas. And this is coming from Reverend Melvin A. Petty, pastor, and Sister Elma Richmond, Resolution Ministry. God bless you, family. Amen.
December 26, 1936. I was born November the 4th, 1936. We were raised as brothers and sisters. And my mother always, and her mother, always tried to dress us like twins. But I'm not going to take up a lot of your time, but I think it's two things that you need to know about Mildred. Mildred was a strong, strong woman.
Yeah.
But she got that from her mother, who was a warrior. In the church, at home, or wherever she was. She was so pathetic about keeping things in order, and her house was always immaculate. She got up early in the morning at 5 o'clock, cooked her dinner for tonight. She washed her clothes. She did everything. The house was immaculate before she left at 7:30 for work. She got Mildred up at 6 o'clock, and Mildred would be crying, "Mama, I'm tired. I want to sleep." But she would get her up, and she would have Mildred put up the dishes. But she would say, "Mildred, do not run. Walk and put the dishes up." The floors were immaculate, waxed at all times. So Mildred get two plates, and she held them up, and she took off and started running. And that slick floor, next thing you know, she slided on the floor. But to show you her tenacity, she held those plates up like this, and she was sliding. She would let those plates fall. Her mother looked at her, and she just, only thing she could do was just laugh, because he was a child that had the tenacity in order to withstand whatever came her way. Right. And she lived that way.
Right, sir.
As her grandson said, she was a strong woman, and she would tell you exactly what was on her mind. And most of the time, it was from the Holy Spirit. So, I'm just here to say today to the family, to take everything that you have learned from her and use it in your life, because it is God will get the glory. And that was her purpose in life. She wanted God to get the glory in her life and in the life of her children. Thank you.
Hall of Charity. Especially to the house, for the Hall of Charity and the family of the house. My mother was a strong woman. I got to give that to her. She fought for a long time. She been through so much. She been through so much. But when I found out she was in the hospital, I went to nursing home, I went to see her. When I hit that door, she smiled and said, "Hi." I said, "What's up?" I always mess with Millie Mill. "What's up, Millie Mill?" Yeah. She said, "I'm tired." I never heard my mother say that. Never in life. After all we've been through. My mother never told me she was tired. But I knew I did. She wasn't going to make me too much longer. She had already given up to what to eat. She knew what she was doing. But I just want to say this. Out of all the things I did to my mother, she never left. She's always right there. Right there, every time. She tell me, why don't you do this? I do. She beat me down. No, I'm getting whooped. No, I'm getting whooped. I stay as long as I can. I ain't going on. Hang out with your dad young. Listen to the music. Hang out with the fellas. I go right back the next week. She never wanted to separate her kids. She never did. I always wanted to be with my dad. She would never let me go. Every year I get kicked out of school. Every year. I ain't coming to that school this year. Man, school here in a week. I ain't lying, but she stood by me. You know, just say, leave, give up on me. And I was in fourth grade, me and Cat had to fight at school. Let down all the curtains, shade. Man, come to the door. Mr. Hall, I know you're in now. You got my little brother with the preacher. Y'all going back to school, so ain't nobody getting in there. Mom, get home. Mom, come home. What you do? Now I'm going to take it no picture today, man. She said, why? I told her, I said, my dad told me I ain't never had to take no picture. She said, well, I'm going to go to college today. My mama only wants to get out of me. I can't ride that.
Right.
She could have been thrown away. I did a lot of stuff out there when I was. One thing I did remember, what my mama always used to say, keep God from
you. Amen.
See, we're mother's surrogate kids. And I like to say that I feel like I'm a special surrogate child.
All right.
Through her son, Kenneth Hall, who became our pastor at Mount Calvary. I got to meet his mother, Mildred Hall. After a few visits to Athens, Mildred became my mom.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you, Kenneth.
Thank you, children, for allowing Mildred to be my surrogate mom. My heart is heavy, but my spirit is all right. Because I know where she is. I know she served a good God. She lived a godly life. She had no shame in letting you know that she was a child of God. And if you were around her any length of time, if you wasn't one, you were going to become one. And I thank God that when I met her, I am and was one. What I liked about Mother, I call her Mother. I ain't calling me that, but I got to know it. It wasn't no Miss Hall, Sister Hall, Mother Hall. It was Mother. I'm a very independent woman, I would say. And I had that, and I finally got married again after like 22 years, and I still had that singleness of mind. Somebody might know what I'm talking about. And Mother and I would be talking, and I'd be complaining about this and complaining about this. Gone, girl. You're no longer single, you're a married woman, and you have to act accordingly. Don't think she didn't get on to me like she did y'all, because she did. But I loved every minute of it. I had the opportunity to go to California, spend a week. I got to go to Berkeley, Mount Zion. She talked about that. I really enjoyed that. Pastor, you may not remember, but I was in the food tasting contest. Didn't even know anybody. But I got to meet so many people just being with Sister Hall. Mother. My diva. My diva, baby. You talk about love to shop and look good. That was our thing. I remember one day she needed some navy blue shoes. That was right up my alley to go shopping, baby. We spent all day long doing what we wanted to do because it was she and I. And I enjoyed that time. Andrea, I'm sorry I took her from you. She was staying at their house about an hour and then she was ready to come to mine. But I loved it. And I just want to say I thank y'all for sharing her with us. And Dexter, you said the other night that if you haven't had a front row experience, keep living. You will have that front row experience. When I had that front row experience, when my mother went on to heaven, she stepped right in. And today, I'm kind of experiencing that same feeling that I had when I had the experience, the front row experience. But she kept me rooted and grounded in my purpose. And for that, I thank you. I just thank you. I'm going to miss her, but I know where she is.
The Lord has made us. That is the scripture that I sent my brother this morning. And I just wanted to stand and tell the Hall family and give my honor to Mother Mildred. I'm glad she moved to California. Because I have no brothers. But Dexter Hall became a brother to me, and I just want the Hall family, I want to tell the Hall family thank you for sharing him with the Berkeley Mount Zion family, but especially to me, to the whole Hall family. I love you. I love you, and Dexter, you know I love you.
Standing on behalf of our family from California, Dexter is our brother. Can't nobody tell us nothing else about Dexter. We will protect him to the end. But our families started together back in Galveston, Texas, even before we was born. And Mildred and my Aunt Joyce went to high school together. We call her Mill Dog. Went to high school together, all the way back in Galveston. And then they came to California, and then we met Dexter, unrelated to knowing that our families had already been connected. So I'm standing here on behalf of my Aunt Joyce, who couldn't be here. Her and Mildred were like this. She literally called me 2 weeks ago and said, give me Dexter Hall number, because I ain't heard from Mildred. And I gave her Dexter's number, and I don't know if that was the last time she talked to your mom, but I just want to tell the Hall family, thank you for embracing us as your sisters and your cousins and your aunties, and we love you, and God bless you. To the family, that I love you,
And I just want to say that we need more mothers like Sister Hall.
All right.
Her house was our safe haven. She gave us a place to have a safe haven, and we children don't have that today. We were able to be teenagers. We were able to grow up and have that safe haven. And I just thank God for her life right now.
Yeah.
I thank God for her, and we can model our lives after her. Like Brayley said, look around you. Look around. Her life, she touched a lot of lives, and we are to live like that. When you have that front row experience, it's not an easy experience. I've been there before. But Dexter, to the whole family, I love you guys. I love you, Pastor, and thank you.
I'm gonna miss my granny just for the simple fact I'm the third oldest of the grandchildren, and she raised me and my sisters. I know I can call my granny anytime for anything. When we grew up in California at Berkeley Mount Zion, we was always at church every Sunday. We had our Easter dresses on. I wouldn't know the Lord's Prayer if it wasn't for my granny. None of us would. It was just one thing that my granny always said, stay in the church, and I did that. And then when she moved, it was like, I couldn't stop calling. I'm like, granny, we're going to have to come out there with you. And she did that. My uncle next to me got on the road, came picked up me and my sister. And when I got old enough to leave, I left. And I've been here ever since. I'm going to miss my granny. She was one of the people that I could just call every day about anything. She told me, quit running the streets, though.
Giving all praises to God, my sister has said what Mother Hall was to us. But going through some notes, I ran across a poem that I wanted to read to the family, my family, because Mother Hall treated me as a child. Entitled Crossing Over. Oh, please don't feel guilty. It was just my time to go. I see you still feeling sad and the tears just seem to flow. We all come to earth for our lifetime, and for some it's not many years. I don't want you to keep crying. You're shedding so many tears. I haven't really left you, even though it may seem so. I have just gone to my heavenly home, and I'm closer to you than you know. Just believe when you say my name, I'm standing next to you. I know you long to see me, but there's nothing I can do. But I still send you messages and hope you'll understand that when your time comes to cross over, I'll be there to take your hand. All the unknown. Come on.
Amen. Can we say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
I don't know about y'all, but y'all sitting here kind of quiet. Any Bible readers in the house? Any Bible readers in the house? The 47th number of Psalms says, oh, clap your hands unto the Lord. Oh, clap your hands unto the Lord. Wait a minute, right over here. Any praises in the house? Would you stand and praise God for Mildred Hall? What about anybody right here? Any family? Would you stand and praise God for Mildred Hall? Would you stand and praise God for Mildred Hall? What mother was a praiser? Does anybody know the Lord in this house? Does anybody know the Lord in this house? Even in the midst of death, the Bible says, I will bless the Lord. Oh, you ought to come on right now. You ought to come on and lift your hands unto God. You ought to give him thanks and praise unto God for the things that he has done. Oh, this is the Lord's doing. And it is marvelous. 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 Great and marvelous is the works of our God. I didn't get up here to say this, but I got a whole nother speech to say. But y'all sitting quiet right now. And my mother was a praiser. This is a celebration. She sat right there about two rows back from where you are about me. Every Sunday at the Great Amount Olive Church when she came. And she would stand, and she would clap, and she would sing, and she would praise, and she would do her dance when she played. She'd hold on to her walker and dance. This is who Mildred Hall was. She was a mother of love. Everything that everybody has said is true. everything that they've seen. Two different sides of a lady who was extremely strong, who was extremely bold, who was extremely unapologetically black. This is who she was. When you think of an only child, y'all sit down real quick. I want all my family to stand. Our oldest relative. It was only the two of them, and I'm so glad that you were able to come. They were raised like brothers and sisters, two first cousins. But the things to know about Granny, about A. Mildred, about Mother, the things to know about her is just as godly as she was, it's just as godly as she was. I'm going to get that on the way home. Because it takes a lot to keep all of these people in line. I'm not talking about you. It takes a lot to keep all of them in line. And she did it. And she did it. Let me tell you, if you ever, anybody know the word unconditional? Does anybody know what the word unconditional means? Unconditional means no matter what, no matter what you did, no matter what you said, no matter where you were and no matter where you had been, she had an individual relationship with every single person here. And when I say every single person, she sat in that chair, if you ever went by 706, she had her phone book on that stand, and she talked from early in the morning to late at night to all of these people. She knows about everything. But some folks in this audience right here are glad. Some of them are glad, not me. Yeah, me too. Because she just left with all the secrets. She just left with all the secrets. Because she knew them all. And she didn't tell anybody. And so we thank and praise God for her. Let me say to Pastor Petty and the Greater Mount Olive Church, we thank and praise God for you and the tutelage in which you have taken my mother in and how he has served here. But not only that, but how you have served her as well. We thank and God praise God for the Berkeley Mount Zion Church, where she stood in Berkeley, California for over 16 years, where she stood and brought me up in that church. Brought me up and helped me to grow in the admonition of God. We thank God for you, Pastor Hunter, for being here from Berkeley, California. To Pastor Irving as well in the Pleasant Grove Church, we thank and praise God for you. So even after my brother left, she stood in that church until it became hard. Y'all know in 82 years, my mother never drove a car. But I take that back. One of y'all members gave her the key because they were feeling sick and told her, you drive us home. Now, I don't know what they did that for. She put the car in reverse, and I think that was the story right there. But in 82 years, 8 months, and 8 days, my mother never drove a day in her life. But yet and still, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. She got everywhere that she needed to be. Everywhere. Walking and all. Grandchildren and all. She got everywhere that she needed to be. And so we thank you. It does not go unnoticed the kindness that many of you have given unto my mother. The things that you've done for her. Linda got up and spoke. Many of you know when my mother got cancer a few years ago, we were in Houston for about 8 weeks. 8 weeks. Back and forth from the hospital every single day. We created a schedule. I flew in from California. My sister was there. But not only was my sisters there, but other folks who loved my mother were there. So whether Kendrea was there, Terry was there, Linda, not even her child, was there. Valencia, not even her child, was there. All of these folks took turns to be with her while she stayed in Houston those entire 8 weeks. I salute all of you today for the work that you have done for my mother. Amen. Brothers and sisters, I thank and praise God for you and the work that you've done. To my oldest brother, at times it doesn't seem like he could do much, but let me tell you, when he came in from Oakland, California, or Vallejo, California, if you will, he'd get in there and he'd fuss at mama, and he'd get right on his knees before his mother and just start rubbing her feet and start rubbing her legs and then get on Jackie and talk about, you need to do this to mama. You ain't doing it right. This is why she ain't walking right, because y'all ain't doing it. He did what he can. My brother Dwayne, Lord Jesus, They fuss and argue and everything else and stuff. But yet at the same time, no greater love does he have than his mother. And if anybody knows him, say something like that about his mom, they're going to turn the church out. Oh, gee, bring him on out, Brother Wayne. That's better to smile. To my sister, one of my mother's caretakers, Kathy, thank you very much for the work that you did with mother. To my sister, her caretaker, all they did was fuss all day long. They just fussed and fussed and fussed like two grown women. Thank you, Jackie. Thank you for the work that you did with mother. Thank you for all that you did, for being with her. To my brother, Kenneth, thank you. In the midnight hour, when nobody else was there, mother would turn and just holler, Kenny, Kenny. And you couldn't play sleep if you know her, because she was going to keep hollering until. She was in the hospital, and the nurse said all she kept hollering all night long was, nurse, nurse. I know you're out there, nurse. I know you're there. She had to go on in there. She said so much one night, she just moved her desk right on outside of mother's room. Thank you, Della, for everything that you've done for her, for all the work that you put in, taking care of her, making sure that she was dressed always 100%. One of her favorite suits that we were able to bury her in. You purchased that suit. Thank you so much. Thank you, Babin. I think in a lot of ways, my mother missed her sisters. And you and Terry began to represent that to her. In a lot of ways, she missed them so much. This horn reminded me that my mother and my aunt Charlemagne, they graduated at the same time at the New Hope Baptist Church. That mother marched the class of 1954 in at A.J. Moore High School. And for those of you who are not familiar, it was the color school. Yeah. Amen, somebody. That's what they called them back then. Mother said they were talking about names, talking about Jerry Johnson and the name. Mother said, no, that was the colored school. That's what they called it. But mother said, Ms. Horn said they marched in. And mother was first because she was the shortest. And then Charlie May was right behind her. And let me tell you, they stood that close. They stood that close a lifetime. And they have bled our family so close that we don't even know that our bloodlines have never crossed. Because in our eyes, they're so mixed up and twisted up. Because my cousin Tony spoke about how can all these people stay in a two-bedroom house. And for those of you who've been at 706 Hubert Street, at any point in time, you could have 15 to 20 people staying in that house when we were growing up. But that's the love that we had. That's the love that families don't have anymore, y'all. That we take in everybody, no matter what it is that you've done. To all of the folks who came and traveled from California, from everywhere, far and near, thank you for everything that you've ever done for this lady. This was my heart. Some 18 months ago, I was here in December, and Pastor Petty, I got on the plane, and when I left my mother a little over 2 years ago, I cried the entire time home. It was the first time in life that I began to recognize, that I began to see the frailties in my mother. A lady, y'all know this story, y'all got it for y'allself, a lady that I thought would live forever. I began to see cracks. I began to see things that were no longer the same. This lady, who was my world. Y'all know this story. Y'all got your own story, too, with your mothers. You know what I'm talking about. I cried all the way home. When I got back to California, I opened up the jobs report from Wells, and I found a job here in Waco. And that was in December. And in February of that month, I moved home so that I could help take care of her.
See, she gave everything for me. And who was I not to be with her in her last and final days? I changed my whole world for her because she changed her whole world for me when she took me to California. Met some of the best folks in my life now. Grew relationships. This was the lady that she was. She returned home. I returned home. Everything that I could. Shirley Caesar says, yeah, this faded rose is all I have to give. But mother, I tried. My only failure, only one in everything that we did, is that in this last battle, I think she held on long enough. Not because she wasn't ready, but because she knew I was not ready.
That's right. Yes.
And I gotta tell y'all, I'm still not ready. I did everything that I could, but this last thing I could not do. This was the Lord's doing. And it is marvelous in His sight.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Best. I know time has been far spent. Dexter has given me instructions not to read it all. So I'm going to try to read just some excerpts. Mother Mildred Yvonne Branch Hall, a story of courage, strength, and faithful, and a faithful God. Resourceful, fearless, strong, bold, unapologetically Black. Fierce, loving, kind, and fiercely independent are words to describe Phil and Willie Juanita's baby girl, Mildred Yvonne Branch Hall. Born on the Texas island of Galveston, Texas, on December 26, 1936, I was born into strength that was culturally given and uniquely mine, that had been passed through my lineage from my grandmother, my aunt, and my mother. Skip down. Mine was a story of three cities: Galveston, Texas, Waco, Texas, and Oakland, California. That was the primary backdrop of my life. All of them made me, nurtured me, fortified me, and grew my faith and strengthened God.
All right.
Graduating in 1954, I was a part of the last graduating class of A.J. Moore High School. We graduated on May 28, 1954 at the New Hope Baptist Church. I was proud to have led the class and followed by my sister Charlie Mae. They said it was because I was the shortest. You think? I am a proud alum, and I helped plan many celebrations for our alumni association. I'm gonna skip down. In 1995, my family experienced one of the greatest losses when my grandson, Nicholas, passed away and returned to Waco, California in 1996 to support my only daughter, Jacqueline, as we together rebuild our lives after this tragic loss. In returning to Waco, I also brought my granddaughters, Antoinette, Dominique, Siobhan, and Brittany. Woo child. Four girls and a little old lady. What a reality show it could have been. I'll let them write the book. Upon my return to Waco, I continued to increase my growth and faith in God at the Pleasant Grove Baptist Church in Balsam, California, Texas, under Kenneth B. Hall. Yep, my son.
Throughout my life, I have worked to help people through nursing, dietary services, and my favorite love, working with children at the Patrick Daycare in Oakland, California, and Mrs. Horn's Daycare in Waco, Texas, as well as being babysitter to many kids like Robert, Imani, Cameron, Hannah, Kayla, Kaylee, TJ, and many others. This was part of my ministry, as I was able to help many young people as they began and grew their families. They called me a matriarch, and I realized the responsibility that goes with such a title. I also realized the void it is now left in each of my children and in all the families that make up my family. The Branches, the Halls, the Ramseys, the Longs, the Princes, and many others. I ask you to keep them lifted always. Be there for them in word and in deed. Always show the love of Christ that they will need to get through this time and continue to prosper in the years to come. I have done my work. The foundation has been laid.
Yes.
And now I am counting on you. Lionel Silas, my cousin brother, my children, Rodney Branch, Dwayne Hall, Reverend Kenneth B. Hall, Jacqueline Hall Taylor, Dexter R. Hall, my daughters-in-law, Kathy, Andrea, Erica, my son-in-law, Thomas, my grandchildren, Patrick, Mercedes, Ladarius, Antoinette, Dominique, Andrea, Siobhan, Justin, Julian, Brittany, DeMonte, Kenneth, Lil Man, Dijon, Shalandria, Reagan, Kennedy, Madison, my great-grandchildren, Raylan, Jemiah, Cameron, Kentrell, Shakori, Jada, Albert, Allion, Yana, Lemire, Omaria, Madison, Dijon, and Aaron. Now, I've been blessed after the passing of my sisters and families to count Babin, Sumjit, J. Nigel, Chris, Casanova, Tony, Greg, Terry, and Camille, and my children and their children as my grandchildren. God also gave me with special relationships that have continued to grow with my daughters, Della and Barbara, and their children, Alex, Ashley, and Anaya. I also have been fortunate to have an awesome neighbor and friend, Valencia, and her sons and grandchildren. Cynthia, I couldn't forget you, as you are a daughter beloved. Dee Dee and Linda, thank you for being my daughters beloved. Thank you.